What you need for spring. Spreaders, hose, and sprayers are on sale. Save 15% off wide span shelving for all your storage needs. And for your yard, a folding picnic table or six burner gas grill. To put your spring in motion, shop the Max Spring Sale. Sign up for email to receive our flyer at maxhardware.com. We're not just another hardware store. We're Max.
Attention landowners. Yankton County is rewriting the zoning ordinances specific to agricultural districts. The right to farm covenants are topics of discussion. Come learn from an expert, Brian Donahoe, about right to farm covenants. If you are a farm or acreage owner, you need to attend. Come to the farm forum, Yankton Archery Center, Monday, April 12th at 7 p.m. Sponsored by Families Feeding Families Agbacy, supporting your right to eat and our right to farm.
Starting a John Deere dealership during the Depression took guts and vision, but C.J. Grossenberg was determined to help the community. He supplied more than equipment. He supplied a better way of life for his neighbors. Today, the family business is still going strong, because round here, Grossenberg proves our value to the community every day. C.J. wouldn't have it any other way. Visit Grossenberg.com for our special offers on John Deere tractors, balers, and ag equipment.
How much of your corn seed actually makes you money? Hi, I'm Darren Hefty, the Hefty Seed Company. Establishing strong early emergence is essential to achieving yields in the fall. And as a farmer, it's frustrating to pay for corn seed just to have it not come out of the ground, or worse yet, emerge too late to do you any good. For example, if you plant your corn at 32,000 plants per acre with a 300 bushel yield goal and you only harvest 30,000 ears, you've already lost nearly 20 bushels of yield potential. At Hefty Seed, we're tired of seeing stand loss in fields. Luckily, in many cases, this problem is very preventable. The difference is the seed treatment. That's why we developed Hefty Complete, the industry's leading corn seed treatment with more than 35 components designed to improve emergence and keep your plants healthier all throughout the season. Hefty Complete comes standard on our seeds. When you plant Hefty brand, you can be sure that every seed's got its best chance to be profitable for you. Learn more about the benefits of Hefty Complete at heftyseed.com.
And we're big on the farm.
This is WNAX Yankton. Check out the impressive capability of the Ford F-150 at buyfordnow.com. It's 6 o'clock.
On the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College, this is the John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Covey Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Believe in Possibility, Member FDIC, Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a Jackrabbit game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First Bank and Trust, because everyone should play hard and bank easy. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome to the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you with us on this Monday night inside Dana J. Dykal Stadium's West Tower. We are on the sixth floor as the Jackrabbit football team is getting set for its final game of the regular season and a return to football action after a layoff of over 3 weeks. The SDSU football team hopefully back on Saturday to take on the Bison of North Dakota State in Fargo. All that's on the line, the Missouri Valley Football Conference Championship, a potential number one seed, certainly a very high seed in the FCS playoffs, home games, and all the like. So there's a lot to be gained this week, but first and foremost, fun to be back with you and talking a little football again, Coach.
Yeah, it's exciting. A border marker trophy also, a lot at stake.
Yeah, the Dakota marker, exactly.
Yeah, so, it's exciting. Our guys have a bounce in their step. You know, we've kind of delved into North Dakota State just a little bit, a couple times, and then withdrawn. And so our guys are full speed ahead, practicing right now, in fact.
Yeah, and Yogi Berra, we want to quote him, it gets late early out there, not that nobody goes anymore, it's too crowded, not when you come to a fork in the road, take it, but it's deja vu all over again. It's Groundhog Day. We've been here before. We've been talking here, and finally we get back to football. How jacked is that locker room? How excited is this crew to have a football game to prep for on Saturday?
Well, I think they're not jacked as much as they're focused, okay. You know, mature, know what's at stake. You know, you mentioned some of it. You know, again, this is a special time of year when you have a chance for playoffs, and that goal that you've worked hard is within reach, you know. And so I think our guys are really focused and mature, like I said, and I'm excited to see the film after practice tonight.
Now, again, it has been 3 weeks since you played. It'll be 28 days between games when it's all said and done. So we've had this conversation, but is there concern of rust when you consider that you haven't played a game in almost a month?
In the fundamentals, yes. Okay. Not in the schemes and so on. I mean, our guys know those things. Very seldom at this point in the season do you put something in new. You know, you go into your bag and you pull some stuff out. Maybe you didn't use that SIU game, but still it was learned back in August. And so, but tackling, blocking, pad height, those types of things, maybe a little rusty. But, again, that's what we've harped on as coaches. So, again, the emphasis is that, and we'll be ready.
What was this past Saturday like for you and for the guys?
You know, I was disappointed. Like we talked, we didn't get to play the University of South Dakota.
Yep.
Our whole family came back. Lori and my whole family came back, and so four grandkids in town, and all the kids and the in-law children. And so for me, I forgot the USD game and dove into those guys. We had our own Easter egg hunt, and so I mean, again, I think you know me. Every day can be a positive day, and the weekend was a positive.
Well, the SDSU football team, of course, has been waiting and waiting for its opportunity, and finally it will be here. What we can tell you, and we'll delve into some more things here at the Missouri Valley Football Conference as the hour goes along, but the automatic qualifier from the Valley as far as who will be in the FCS playoffs will come from Saturday's game. The winner of that game will receive the AQ, as they call it. Doesn't mean that the loser won't get into the playoffs. In fact, in chatting with the conference office, they feel very confident, as they should. I mean, we saw in the playoff committee's one ranking a couple of weeks ago that SDSU and North Dakota State are both in the top three. I mean, if that's the case, then you feel like the loser of this game shouldn't be penalized too much and would still be in. But whoever wins the game Saturday not only wins the Dakota marker, not only wins at least a share of a Valley championship, but that automatic qualifier, and that is a big deal.
It is a big deal, and I think, you know, again, they're playing at home. If we're lucky enough to go on the road, beat them at their place, and all those other things that come, I think there's a statement made nationally that you're able to do that in a place that's really hard to play. Their record is really good, as ours is here at our stadium. So we just need to go up there and play. We need to be 1-0 every play, and we'll be fine.
We're going to talk more with the head coach about this Jackrabbit football team, kind of reset things a little bit. We'll have plenty of time to discuss North Dakota State and more coming up on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, here on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Walk these fields for 8 decades. Grow deeper roots here. Know it thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like Chrome Triple Stack Corn Hybrids and Enlist E3 soybeans. Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Hogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields. Challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Okay, Jacks fans, let's make some noise.
Go Jacks! Okay, Jax fans. Normally, Keep Farmers Farming Manager Alan Hoyer would be cheering about how South Dakota farmers can secure their legacies for generations to come with a little thoughtful financial planning. But when he's at a Jax game, the only banking Alan does is bank some noise.
Go Jax!
Bank some noise with us at firstdakota.com. Member FDIC.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages. Plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
Here's a pop quiz for corn growers. Of the top three seed corn brands in the Central Corn Belt, only one is 100% focused on seed corn. U.S. farm family owned and got there without the help of a parent company. Any guesses? That's right. Wiffles Hybrids. Officially making them the grown-up in the field. Wiffles Hybrids. One thing done right.
Welcome back to President Dr. Barry Dunn's suite on the sixth floor of Dana J. Dykal Stadium and the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. I'm Tyler Merriam with the head football coach of the Yellow and Blue, John Stiegelmeier. Had a little hiccup in segment one with the video, but thanks to the great work of our man Chris McDaniel, we are back on live. And so we were radio only, literally. People couldn't even see us on YouTube, Coach.
The radio show, but good. I think that it's appropriate to go over the sandwich because that's kind of the highlight of the show. So you ready to do that?
Absolutely, I am. Every week, Cubbies has a special feature, and we love to highlight it to tell you what you're missing out on or what you need to check out at Cubbies. And this week's feature, it is the brisket melt.
Sounds good. Sounds really good.
Nodding in agreement. We're going to get him a napkin because he's drooling. The brisket melt is brisket with smoky barbecue sauce. It has red onion. It has Havarti cheese and applewood smoked bacon. And it looks like it's not on traditional hamburger bun, and it would be on a piece of toast, it would appear, so because it's a melt.
I think it's worthy of a trip to Cubby's.
It's always worthy of a trip to Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, located on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. Great to have you alongside on this Monday. Let us set the stage again for you. Saturday afternoon, 2:30 Central Time, inside the Fargo Dome, South Dakota State at North Dakota State, with a ton on the line. Ton of options for this one. We'll obviously have radio coverage throughout our Jackrabbit Sports Network, the TuneIn app, the Jackrabbit app, starting at 1:30 with Alex Parker, Scotty Quaz, and myself. In addition to that, the game will be available on ESPN Plus or here in South Dakota from our friends at Midco Sportsnet. There'll be multiple television broadcasts of this one. We'll obviously have radio coverage. Should be a lot of fun. And again, we look at where the Missouri Valley Football Conference sits right now. Two teams are 5-1, North Dakota State and Missouri State. Then North Dakota and South Dakota State are each 4-1. You have 3-3 Southern Illinois, 3-4 Northern Iowa, 1-3 Illinois State, 1-3 South Dakota, 1-5 Western Illinois, and 1-6 Youngstown State. Now, to complete this picture, the Missouri Valley announced earlier this year, and it makes total sense, with the uniqueness, if you end with the same number of losses, even if you don't have the same number of wins, you will win a share of a conference championship. So Missouri State at 5-1 doesn't play this week. They've won a share of a conference title. First year for Bobby Petrino there, everything that program's been through, that's a heck of an accomplishment for the Bears.
It is, and it's been fun to, literally fun to watch the program develop because you get the games through exchange and so on. In fact, I emailed Coach Petrino yesterday and congratulated him. Huge improvement And I love Dave Steckel, the old head coach. I literally love him. You know, but that's a – you get new blood. You know, sometimes a different voice, you know, is what you need. I'm sure coming from where he came from, he got a bigger commitment to the program, which is always improvement. And he's got some really good athletes to do the thing with, to play the game with. So happy for the Bears.
Now, the Bears are 5-4 overall because they played three games in the fall and lost all three of them, but they've played so well here in the spring. Now, they're, again, guaranteed at least a share of a conference championship, but it'll be tough to see them making the playoffs, again, with a 5-4 overall mark. If North Dakota State at 5-1 wins on Saturday, it is 6-1 and will be the automatic qualifier out of the Missouri Valley. If SDSU wins on Saturday, Jax will be 5-1 with Missouri State, potentially North Dakota as well, and you get into common opponents and whatnot, and the only common opponents that all three have, there would be four of them, and the one that would break it would be North Dakota State, because in that scenario, Missouri State and UND both have lost to the Bison. The Jax would have beaten North Dakota State by virtue of a win on Saturday, so that would give SDSU the automatic qualifier, I should say, and avoid having an at-large. So that's the scenario. Now, there's some other scenarios if not every game gets played, and Mike Kern and I were talking about that, and I said, Mike, let's not even go there. We're going to be positive. We're going to get all these games in on Saturday, and it's going to happen. But again, we look, the Valley feels really good that two teams are in, and both the Bison and the Jacks. They're optimistic that North Dakota is in regardless, certainly with a win. UND's at Youngstown State this week at 5-1. It would be in. When you're talking about an abbreviated 16-team field, only six at-larges now. If two of them come out of the Missouri Valley, and Southern Illinois will play a nationally ranked Southeastern Louisiana team this weekend, they're optimistic if they win and get to 5-3 that they'd be in the discussion, and certainly they'll be in the discussion. We'll have to see how it plays out, but even if it's only two at-larges out of six, it again talks about the power of the Missouri Valley.
I think that would be I think it'd be amazing to get two in based on only six at-large teams. But again, like you're saying, like you defined, it defines or explains the power of our conference. Mm-hmm. I feel for Missouri State because on a normal year, they may have a chance to get in. If SIU beats Southeast Louisiana, they would have a chance to get in. But those are cards were dealt. Everybody knew that. That's why we've been talking about since the UND game is you got to be 1-0 every day, which hopefully leads to be 1-0 on Saturdays because those are important. Every play is important.
No, certainly everything is magnified at this point. We start talking about the future because we'll get into everything here with this game coming up in a moment, but I want to touch a little bit on what's coming up because we've been talking about the future. We've been talking about the fall and how we hope to get back to normal this fall with fans in the stands. And on Friday, Dana Dykhouse, who, of course, the name is on the stadium, and Justin Sell made an announcement down at First Premier Bank's new corporate offices in Sioux Falls that Jax Bash 2 is coming to Brookings Wednesday, September the 8th, as sort of a kickoff to a return to normal, we all hope, as we're all getting our vaccines. I got my second one yesterday. I know you've gotten yours, Coach. And now with this big concert, you being the music lover that you are, you've got Zach Brown Band, Fall Out Boy, among others. An exciting first event that was, the original Jax Bash. Hard to believe it's been 4.5 years since that happened, and now we have Jax Bash 2 coming up in September.
Well, I think you know, it's exciting. It's going to be a huge event. It's we have a great venue, so all those things are positive. But let's go to the foundation. Dana Dykhouse, mm-hmm. First Premier Bank, First Premier Card, and their support of this region. You know, look at all the places they have impacted. And so just thanks to Dana and his family, thanks to Premier and to make this happen, because it does draw light to attention to our stadium, our university, and really the region. And so what a great supporter of South Dakota State.
And specifically Jackrabbit football as well, because I can tell you, going down there and talking with Dana for a few minutes before it all started, we're talking about conference automatic qualifiers and Missouri State. And I mean, he's plugged in. He's following what's going on, and he's excited about Jackrabbit football.
Well, Dana made one prediction many years ago, and I've asked him not to do it anymore. But yeah, he is tuned in. One of the coolest things in my world with Dana is since we've built the Dykhouse Student Athlete Center, he has greeted the new freshmen really in our team meeting the first or second day of fall camp. really has the same message, but it's a powerful message in what this body of people really is going to mean, what it means now, what it's going to mean down the road. And he gets emotional. He's brought up his best friend who played with him, Ron Fuon. Yep. He's brought up Matt Sutton, who played in the 50s, and talked about that. Matt's added, and it's really, you know, again, because I've been here so long and Dana's attached, so it's really become a tradition for us during fall camp. He created a new award for us, kind of impromptu, and so really, really appreciate Dana.
It's fun chatting with him. He has such great perspective on everything and can tie things up in such a neat manner. But nevertheless, appreciate him. And you know what? We should give a special shout-out to folks who are reaching out. When we had a little hiccup here at the top with the video, but so many people excited about what's going on here at SDSU, whether it is just Jackrabbit football, Jackrabbit sports, South Dakota State University as a whole. You've got a loyal group of Jackrabbits who've been chomping at the bit to come out and support you. And I know they're looking forward to what we hope to be a traditional fall football schedule with a lot of games in this stadium and a lot of people in these seats.
Yeah, you know, again, I'm a play in the present guy, so it's hard for me to think about or worry about or discuss a full stadium and fall and all those things. You know, again, I just talked to the team before practice started and said we needed to be 1-0, and I believe we'll be that today. And, you know, I look forward to the fall, but really we've got some special things ahead of us right now.
And we'll be talking about those in just a moment. When we come back, we'll discuss this football team right now, where it's at, and also the Bison of North Dakota State, the opposition on Saturday with the Dakota Marker, the automatic qualifier, and a conference championship out of the Missouri Valley all on the line. The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show is presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, and you're listening to the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
At Wiffles Hybrids, our family recipe for success has been handed down for three generations. Take two parts high-performing hybrids, mix with one part unmatched quality, then finish it off with our secret sauce, superior customer service. Some people may say it's impossible to get the best hybrids from an independent, family-owned company, to which we'd say, have your cake and eat it too. Mmm, Wiffles Hybrids, quite possibly the best hybrids you can buy.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
The past year, we've taken some things for granted, such as the importance of a consistent food supply chain, gathering in large groups, and the fall football season. Just as SDSU football is innovating to offer spring football games, so too is the ag industry constantly innovating to provide a safe and reliable supply of affordable and healthy food for your family's table. South Dakota Farm Bureau's game plan is to find wins for agriculture by supporting the industry through policy development and advocacy. South Dakota Farm Bureau, proud supporter of SDSU athletics. Go Jacks!
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
Let's be real. You earn, you save, you plan,
you protect. If you want to secure your legacy, First Bank and Trust offers savvy financial planning from people who understand where you are and where you want to go. We can help you navigate your options and build for the future, whatever that may be. We're big enough to help you plan for tomorrow and small enough to start with today. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal opportunity lender.
Midco Sports Network is proud to bring fans live regional sports coverage. No matter what this season brings, our goal to provide the best local sports coverage remains.
Oh, Jackson. Winicky's got himself open over the middle.
From the field to your screen, Midco Sports Network brings you the best in regional sports coverage.
Touchdown, Jackrabbits.
Midco SN, celebrating 10 years of sports.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. Hi again, friends. Tyler Merriam alongside the man whose Twitter handle is Holy Nutmeg, the head coach of the SDSU football team, Coach Stig himself. Jackrabbits at North Dakota State Saturday afternoon, 2:30, the scheduled start time. Airtime at 1:30 on these Jackrabbit Sports Network stations, the Jackrabbit app, the TuneIn app, gojacks.com/watch, wherever you tune in to SDSU football. On this show, we like to dig into things with Coach Stig. Now, we talked last week about how you were going to whip up some stew for the coaching staff.
Wild rice soup.
Wild rice soup, excuse me. It wasn't stew, it was soup. How was the wild rice soup?
Well, didn't get a lot of comments until the next day when John Schaefer said, you know, Coach, we could have that meal every day around here. So I considered it okay, passed.
Okay,
so
what's on the menu for this week?
Tacos.
Doing tacos.
Yep.
Okay. And we always, again, want to know about other items in Coach Stink's life. So let's discuss the wardrobe today. We've got the National Guard polo shirt.
Yeah, well, first of all, I like free. And Chad Holland, who's, I don't know if he's still in town, but was the head of the National Guard recruiting office here. And during the military appreciation, he would serve us or give us the military pants that we'd wear. And one year he gave me this, and I'm honored, to be honest with you. I'm honored to wear it and support our military, any of our military. Well, a couple of years later, we had T.J. Carlson had a relative come who had served in the Army and gave a phenomenal message to our team about what he learned in the Army and how to apply it to life and football. And I gave him some shirts, and he pulled a shirt out of his bag and gave me an Army shirt. And then one day, unique, I was wearing one of them at the Difference Makers Club, and Maury Forsyth was there, who the son of Harry Forsyth, or one of our past ADs, and he served in the Air Force. In fact, I think he was a four-star general. He took offense to it, and he got me an Air Force shirt. So I've got a whole wardrobe for the military. But on a serious note, I'm honored to wear it and humbled by what they do for our nation. In fact, one of our greatest supporters, one of my greatest SDSU footballs, greatest supporters is Dave Porter out in east in Tennessee, I believe, and just he keeps in really close touch. Has given me his book, which I'm halfway through it, and I know he follows really well and keeps in contact with you. So again, bottom line, love the military, any phase of it, and honored to have a couple shirts to wear and support him.
Oh, that's really cool. That is really cool. Let's talk a little bit about this Jackrabbit football team and where things are at. We've discussed certainly the layoff and the negatives to it potentially, but the positive is that you're getting ready for the last week of the regular season, and I think I can safely say this is the healthiest you've ever been as a football team going into the final week of a regular season.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, if you know our system, every day we have a meeting. Now it's a Zoom meeting, not an in-person meeting. And the process is to start with the athletic trainer, Charlie Miller, and he goes over the injury list. And as mentioned earlier off the air, we had four guys he talked about. Wow. You know, normally it's four guys that can't play and another 15 handful of guys that are on and off and potential and get this many reps and so. So really blessed. So, there's a positive in everything. You know that. And that's one of the huge positives. And if we're able to get into the playoffs and do some things, that's going to really pay dividends.
I thought it was interesting, too, when I asked you about the rust, and you said maybe from some of the particulars when you get into the games on that. But as far as, again, working on the route running, the techniques, the things like that, that this has been a great opportunity for the guys to, I don't know if it's fine-tuning or just making sure that they haven't lost out on anything, because it's easy in the middle of a season maybe to when you're playing games every week to have that slide a little bit, but that hasn't been the case.
No, it hasn't. And again, I said this before, I'm going to credit Shannon Moore out in Wyoming, that they went through some games where they weren't able to play, and they learned from it and how what they could have done better. And he shared that with me before I even thought about the season, really. It was January, December, whatever it was. It put that on my heart. And then, so when we went out to practice, we didn't have a game. We had a mission. We had a vision. And we didn't beat the guys up. And we kept it light. But we encouraged them and charged them with, let's be 1-0 today in this practice and so on. We took some days off. And, again, the bottom line is I am surrounded by unbelievable coaches and unbelievable student athletes. And when you're one heartbeat, one voice, they embrace that and they go do it. And we have gotten better every week.
Mark Gronowski, your quarterback, a true freshman, has rushed for 257 yards in 5 games. That's 51 per game. He's averaging 6 yards a carry. He has 6 rushing touchdowns. He's also completing 55% of his passes for over 900 yards, 7 touchdowns to 3 interceptions. And yet, beyond the numbers, the thing that's most impressed to you, am I correct, is his leadership, the way that he guides that huddle in the offense?
Leadership/confidence, okay. And they go hand in hand. Again, for a true freshman to do what he's doing and not flinch and not wonder if can I do this. I mean, obviously he came in here with the goal to play. Yeah. He was handed the baton, hasn't passed it off. He's going to keep it. Again, a phenomenal talent, works his tail off. But the cool thing is he's only going to get better, and that's what Zach Lujan, his coach, will push him to do. All these practices have allowed him to hone his skill even more.
You're certainly deep at the running back position. Pierre Strong Jr. averaging 5 yards a carry. Isaiah Davis averaging 7.8. Strong missed the last game that you had, which, again, was weeks ago. But you've got Strong, you've got Davis. Certainly go down the line with Meacham as well. You're going to have a very healthy group of running backs headed to Fargo.
Yeah, and I'm excited about every one of those guys. And each will have a part in the game. They're distinctly different. But we need to get Pierre back. I mean, he's kind of the face of the offense, maybe the SDSU football at one point, and get him going. And I don't think he'll be able to carry the ball as many times as he's used to, but that's okay. We've got two guys that are behind him.
Hines, Kraft, Coons, Morgan, Kavanaugh, go down the list at tight end. To be able to use multiple guys at that position and have them healthy, that's what you wanted to do. You've been trying to get them all healthy, and now with how this has all played out, you're ready to be able to use all those weapons.
We are, and we talked early. I thought we'd be out in 20-degree weather and snow, and we'd have to be at two tight ends and play smash-mouth football. We haven't had one game like that, very few practices like that. But that's a good matchup because NDSU has some really good tight ends also. So we'll see who steps up at that position. But I'm excited about our guys.
What do you think of that offensive line and how they've played? And how, to be honest, that's one thing that Jason Eck has done is he's got his 5, and he's ridden those 5, and they've played darn well.
They have, and really happy for Garrett Greenfield. He's playing, he emerged as maybe the fourth guy, and I think he may be playing the best. West Janan. I mean, he's a phenomenal football player. Not that he isn't playing at a high level, but he's always played at a high level. Egan's playing well. The guy that's coming on is Bo Donald. Bo Donald's going to get some more reps at NDSU and really a pup in our program, but really a good football player. And Mason McCormick is a gritty type of guy, so excited about it. And there's guys behind him that can do it too. They're just waiting their turn. But, again, to be on one page, one voice, one heartbeat as an offensive line is imperative.
One thing that continues to impress me both in 2019 and now in this 2020 turn to spring 21 season is how deep you are up front defensively. That front four being able to run in so many different guys, and it doesn't seem to matter which one they are. They all seem to be productive.
Yeah, I give credit to our coordinators, Jimmy and Brian, and then our D-line coaches. They made a commitment. We made a commitment. They forced me to make a commitment, if you will, that we need to change our scholarship numbers. And, you know, you're only allotted so many spots for guys to be on scholarship. And I kind of, as a math guy, I kind of say, well, how many of these guys play? That's so many. And they just said, because guys grow up, they're so important, we need more D linemen on scholarship. We made that commitment, and you're seeing the result mm-hmm. of that we've got some really good football players that you don't miss a beat when they go in.
And certainly at linebacker, you've got the two captains, Backus and Tetzlaff, who are 1 and 2 in tackles, 35 and 34 respectively. Backus with the one-stop lead on Tetzlaff. But beyond that, again, whether it's the box, the Spaldings, we've seen a lot of guys step up and make plays at that position.
Yeah, they're good players also. A lot of those guys are just getting some experience right mm-hmm. now and are going to get that much better. And, you know, I did deviate a little bit here. You know,
yeah.
Last Saturday should have been senior day. Mm-hmm. We had one senior we were going to honor, and that's Preston Tetzlaff. And he had been, like I told the team, he had been able to stand out there with his parents and give his mom a rose and really be celebrated as a true Jackrabbit and a senior that's going out, having done everything we asked him and more. And so, you were part of the video. In fact, you put together the video, I believe. What a neat honor. Thank you for doing that. Hopefully people will watch it in social media because it's a neat tribute to Preston.
And in all fairness, I'd love to say, yes, I did it, but Chris McDaniel is pulling the strings on our video production. He did all the work for it. I just said, yep, that looks good.
Should we have him come in here and smile or –
You want to take a bow?
No, yeah, let's leave him.
He might anger people with that shirt he's wearing. So we'll let the former Lions employee hang out over there. From a defensive back standpoint, with Dyshawn back now, the way Don Gardner's played, able to run some different guys in at cornerback, and that rotation at safety that we've hit on, very athletic. And again, you've been the penalties were the one negative from that group, but the last couple of times out, they seem to have corrected that.
Yeah, when you have something, after we grade guys, I have coaches put down the three things they need to work on the most. And then I look at the practice plans to say, are we working on it? Because a coach would do the same drill every day because they get in this routine. And so it's my job with my position coach, who are the assistant coaches, to get them to create a better situation for their players. And so Rob Erickson specifically, we had a number of more playing press man, we're going down the field and there's some bump and so on. And so really there's been some perfect play out of that technique recently. And then the safeties are playing well, but talk about a mess of guys you can put out on the field, yeah. A bunch of guys and feel comfortable.
Who will snap on Saturday?
Long snap will be Thomas Motzko, the guy that took over for Jaden when he went down and he consequently got injured right away. Yeah. But he's healthy now and snapping really well. Gritzmacher, John, will do the short snapping and is also a long snapper. Zach Wilson can be a long snapper. I talked about this. I'm so proud of our guys. We have this hole that we need to fill. We have three guys step up, and we'd have been fine with any of them. Now, game-wise, I don't know if they'd have been fine, but I'd have been fine believing in them and so on. So Thomas is going to do a good job, and he's a linebacker, so it's natural for him to run down and get involved.
Special teams, and we'll discuss it in a little bit, how good North Dakota State has been on special teams. But for the sake of this conversation, they've been really good on special teams. So you've got the situation where you had a huge forced fumble on a kickoff return that really swung the balance of the game at Southern Illinois and started that ball rolling downhill against SIU. You've had blocked punts. You've made some big plays in the special teams, but to be consistent in that, not to give up big plays as well, not to have blocked field goals, not to give up the fake punt, to finding consistency on that's going to be a big deal Saturday.
It is. Yeah, it is. And North Dakota State is sound in everything they do. I mean, it doesn't matter whether it's kickoff or PAT or get out of that offense, defense. You know, you can't outnumber them on defense, their defense and so on. So we need to just do our job, be good and great in what we do and see what happens. You know, that's football, though. That's football. Block the guys and the other guy's got to tackle you. And, you know, get off a block, stay on blocks. It's really a pretty simple game. And then when you put good players out there, get the call out there and let them play.
We'll talk more with the head coach about North Dakota State and the matchup coming up on Saturday in the Fargo Dome when the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues. We are presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, and this is the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Let's be real. Dream it. You start it. You build it. You grow it. What makes this such a great business community? As a community bank, First is empowered to make local decisions with creative solutions, top-notch online banking, and cash management options. That means no matter the size of your business, we're big enough to help you take your next steps and small enough to get you started with your first. First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experience care available when you need it, treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org.
Walk these fields for 8 decades. Grow deeper roots here. Know what thrives here. Bring in world-class genetics and innovative traits like Chrome Triple Stack Corn Hybrids and Enlist E3 soybeans. Refine it through pure local know-how and expertise. Do all of that, and the only thing left is the right seed. Pogemeyer Hybrids. Learn more at therightseed.com.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Jax, we are proud of you. Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison is proud to be a strong supporter of SDSU Athletics. We know hard work and determination make for a winning team. So when you buy from Prostrallo's, you will experience our winning team. We will do our very best to find the perfect car or truck and even deliver it to your front door. Find the savings and selection you deserve at Prostrallo Auto Mall in Madison. South Dakota strong for 63 years. Go Jax!
30 seconds.
Looking to gain traction on the competition before the next harvest? Spring into savings with end-user instant rebates, where you can get up to $150 back on each Michelin Ag tire you buy at WW Tire. The best part is, there's no quantity limits, so the more you buy, the more you save. Hurry and get in on the savings, because this offer is valid now through May 15th. WW Tire, delivering fast and friendly service across 8 locations in South Dakota.
Welcome back to the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. The brisket melt is the feature of the week at Cubby's. It's located on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. You can get it to go. You can call and place your order. You can sit down and eat in person. You can even check it out while you watch the Jackrabbit football game at Cubby's on Saturday afternoon. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. The SDSU football team, top five in virtually every national poll. On the road at another top five team in every national poll, the Bison of North Dakota State, the regular season finale, the Dakota Marker game, the automatic qualifier, and a Missouri Valley Football Conference championship all at stake on Saturday afternoon, 2:30 p.m. The kickoff will have radio coverage starting at 1:30. I'm Tyler Merriam alongside head coach John Stiegelmeier. And you brought up how sound North Dakota State is. And when you look down at stuff, one number really does stand out. They've only allowed 5 sacks this year. That's sixth fewest in all of the FCS. Beyond that, they're only penalized 3 times per game for 30 yards. Both of those numbers rank in the top 10 nationally. But they've turned it over 12 times this year. They're minus 7 in turnover margin. We're used to seeing the Bison be plus 7 or greater in that stat over the course of a year. That has been an area of concern for Matt Ensa's squad.
Yeah, and sometimes those things just happen, and I don't think there's anything different about their football team. That is a unique stat for a team that's ranked number 2 in the nation to be a negative 7. But we're gonna go after the ball. Obviously, we're gonna try to intercept the ball when it's in the air. But we just have to play our great football. When you look at the stats, which I brought up, you look at every category. Mm-hmm. It's amazing at how close we are in every category. You know, the ones we're low in, many times they're low in. The ones we're high in, the one difference, and you mentioned it, penalties. They're really good. We have working our way back to being average. We need to have a great game in terms of penalties when we're up there.
if there is a difference fans will see is that in previous years with the North Dakota State quarterbacks, there's been so much of that power run game that the quarterback is a part of. Zeb Noland is a tremendous talent, a kid out of Georgia who started his college career at Iowa State. I know he was somebody the Jacks were after at one point when he was looking to transfer, chose North Dakota State. He's a traditional drop-back passer who occasionally will run. He's only tried to run 16 times this year. So while he will run periodically, it's a different way of running the football. That's probably the biggest change as far as the Bison offense is concerned, right?
Yeah, a huge change. And their backup, Cam Miller, I believe is his name, yep. A young guy, they'll run him more. Mm-hmm. Zeb is your normal quarterback, I guess you'd call it, more of a one-dimensional type guy, run the show, hand the ball off. And in their offense, with the power and the G-ISO and the wrap plays and so on, they can survive with that, if you will. Now, I was thinking about it 16 times so far. I mean, there were games that Trey Lance ran the ball over 16 times in a game, and so surely a different philosophy.
And again, some sacks, only 5 of them, but the sacks factor into that number of 16 as well. They have had a number of injuries at the tailback position, so the traditional scat backs, if you will, that sometimes North Dakota State has had on top of those power guys, they don't really have. So they have a converted fullback in Hunter Lupke, who's taken the lion's share of the carries the last couple of weeks. He was the National Offensive Player of the Week after the Bison beat North Dakota back on March the 20th. So he's rushing at 6.5 yards per clip. He's 6'1", 245 pounds. You want to talk about a bowling ball.
Well, and then think about it. I mean, he came in as a fullback, so he's supposed to be blocking for their tailback. Mm-hmm. Credit North Dakota State to figure out a way to get their best 11 guys on the field. Yeah. Their backs are good, all right? Their backs are good. They have lost some guys, but that young man's good. The guy that backs him up is good. Different styles again, so you might have a guy that tries to outrun you, and this kid's going to not outrun you initially. He's going to try to run you over.
And so good at the tight end position. Gindorf and Babich, they've combined now for 22 catches on the year, 3 of them for touchdowns. But these are two guys that it's a cliche having a nose for the end zone. But when they need a big play in the pass game, they oftentimes go to those two tight ends.
Yeah, and that hasn't changed. I mean, that's normal. Yep. And why is that? Well, if you run the football and you run it effectively, the guy that has the tight end is also involved in the fit of the running play. And so, again, I've said it for decades, the best play in football, if you run the football, is play action pass, and that's when those tight ends quite often get open. Now, the one had, I think they had 2 touchdowns in the UNI game, but the one was kind of a trick play that they caught him, and credit to them that they caught UNI in a defense that they didn't have it covered.
Maybe the best athlete the Bison have is Christian Watson, the 6'4 wideout out of Tampa, who had a kickoff return for a touchdown of 100 yards against UNI, caught 2 passes for 86 yards. Both of them were pivotal plays in the game. Watson, they will run the football with him. He has 13 carries this year in the Jet sweep game. He has 13 receptions on the year, and he's averaging over 23 yards per reception. So you want to talk about the definition of a big play threat, that's Christian Watson.
Yeah, that the kickoff return against UNI was huge in the game. Mm-hmm. His catches were huge. He's a really good talent, and again, I always use Jake Winicky. Just get it close to a young man like that because he's so big, and he towers over every corner in our league, and so a really good football player.
Defensively up front, like the Bison of the past, they're going to run a lot of guys in up front, and they've got guys from all over, from South Dakota, North Dakota, Missouri, Minnesota, Florida, Wyoming, Wisconsin, but they run a lot of guys in, and they're physical up front.
They are, and they pride themselves in that, and that's the kind of football, that's the kind of offense they play, so you're going to have a physical defensive line. I think their defensive line is one of their strengths on their football team. I think their DNs are really good. Their nose guard, tackle are physical type guys, hold it. And then their line, their football team is good, really good.
And Josh Hayes, Michael Tutsi, 2 veterans at the defensive backfield, 1 at corner, 1 at safety, anchoring a defensive unit that you look at the numbers, they're not jaw-dropping. They're just really good. It's not as if they have this one stat that jumps out. You go, man, they're second in the nation in this, but they're top 15 in scoring defense, top 20 in total defense, top 20 in rushing defense. They're top 20 in third downs. They're just really good at everything.
Well, they play good defense. They always have. Again, some teams you can – run a motion or do a shift or do a whatever, and you outnumber them. And so you go through the line, and somebody's going to tackle you from the other side of the formation because you out-schemed them. never does it happen against North Dakota State. And so you might be able to get this guy to tackle you, but there's always going to be a tackler. There's always going to be a guy in the zone. You're not going to know. They do a lot of disguise type stuff, so you're not going to know what coverage they're in. They're a good football team. And, again, this defense, I don't know who it started with, but it's been handed down for years, and the tweaks always come, but they're good.
Watson, a kickoff return for a touchdown, one of 14 that's happened in the FCS this spring. Jaden Price has one of 15 punt return touchdowns. That was a huge play against Illinois State a few weeks ago. And then Garrett Wagner, the punter, a 46.8-yard average. He is the leading punter average-wise in the nation, the reigning special teams player of the week in the Missouri Valley. 16 of his 35 punts have landed inside the 20, and then out of his other 19, 11 of them have gone for 50 or more. So we talk about guys who can throw the deep ball as a quarterback but also have the touch over the middle on the short throws. Wagner can do both as a punter, stick you in the coffin corner or just let the thing fly.
Yeah, he's a phenomenal talent. And when you flip the field, when you turn the ball over, when you stop him in third down, they really don't miss a beat because he's going to kick the heck out of the ball, and it's going to be tough to return it because not only is it long, it's high. He's a very good football player, very good punter.
All right, that's a scouting report on the Bison of North Dakota State. The opposition on Saturday afternoon. We'll wrap things up on the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. When you return to President Dunn's Digs, we're inside the suite of the SDSU president here at Dana J. Dykal Stadium on the sixth floor of the West Tower. Stay tuned. The John Stiegelmeier Radio Show continues, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, right here on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Becoming America's best-selling brand means you never settle. Like the Ford F-150, completely rebuilt from the ground up to be smarter and tougher than ever. Or the Ford Bronco Sport, with a legacy that can't be broken. The entire Bronco family is designed, engineered, and built for adventure. Plus, Ford's complete lineup of SUVs gives you the power, style, and space you need for life on the go. Go to buyfordnow.com or contact your local Northland Ford dealer for exclusive offers on the perfect Ford for you. Sales claim based on calendar year sales.
Here's a pop quiz for corn growers. Of the top three seed corn brands in the Central Corn Belt, only one is 100% focused on seed corn. U.S. farm family owned and got there without the help of a parent company. Any guesses? That's right. Wiffles Hybrids. Officially making them the grown-up in the field. Wiffles Hybrids. One thing done right.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Director's Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
In South Dakota, farming is more than cornfields and combines. It's the small moments and big challenges we all face every day. It's getting up in the morning, taking care of what needs to be done, doing the best you can, and being thankful for the opportunity to do it again tomorrow. This is real. This is life. This is farming. To learn more about farming, visit thisisfarming.org. Brought to you by South Dakota Corn.
Spend more moments in the moment, not in pain, with orthopedics and sports medicine care from Sanford Health. Our team is here to help you overcome joint issues, athletic injuries, and anything else holding you back. Experience care available when you need it, treatment options that go beyond the expected, and a plan that is made just for you. So together, we can find your way forward. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org.
Experience the benefit of Blue with a Medicare supplement plan from Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield. With our plans, you'll enjoy nationwide access to care, optional dental, vision, and hearing coverage, and more. Call 1-888-616-8927 or go online to wellmark.com/Medicare plans. You may even qualify for a special household discount. This is the benefit of Blue. Wellmark Blue Dental product available to Iowa residents only. Must reside in the service area of the plan. Wellmark Medicare supplement insurance plans are not connected with or endorsed by any government agency.
Okay, Jacks fans, let's bank some noise.
Go Jack!
Okay, Jacks fans, when he's at SDSU, First Dakota Chairman of the Board and CEO Larry Ness is usually getting pumped up about investing in new ideas by educating tomorrow's financial leaders through the First Dakota E-Trade Lab. But when the Jacks hit the field, the only banking activity Larry does is bank some noise.
Go Jack!
Bank some noise with us at firstdakota.com. Member FDIC.
Thanks to Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, the presenting sponsor of the John Stiegelmeier Radio Show. I'm Tyler Merriam. He's the head coach of the SDSU football team. And the Jackrabbits will be in Fargo on Saturday, provided everything goes as planned. SDSU and North Dakota State to meet 2:30 p.m. is the scheduled kickoff time, regular season finale, and a Missouri Valley Football Conference championship on the line. Then on Sunday, we'll find out about the FCS playoffs, and we know that the NCAA has selected South Dakota State as a potential host site for the NCAA FCS playoffs, not just for the opening round, but for beyond. But with this unique year, we'll just take it week by week to see who hosts and when they host.
Well, yeah, and this might sound kind of funny to our fans, but Slade Larson, my supervisor said we may host a game that we're not even playing
it's
in.
It's possible,
you know?
Yes.
You know, because there will be teams in the playoffs that aren't going to be hosts, so they've got to go somewhere. And I know the NCAA is going to try to figure this out to take care of all teams in the playoffs, not just some seeds and so on. So it'll be an interesting time, and we're part of history, so I look forward to it.
We certainly are a part of history. You have a history in the Fargo Dome. You know how loud that place can be. It will not have the same exact fervor because it won't be full, just like Dana J. DeKalb Stadium didn't have the same exact feeling that it does during a traditional fall. But you know the folks that will be there will be loud, and they will make as much noise as humanly possible.
Yeah, most of the time I've set myself up to be yelled at in answering this question or commenting. So, you know, they have what we all want, right? They have fans that come just like we do, that any team wants. They have fans that come, they love the team, and they want to impact the game. And I got to believe, because they only get 50%, they come with 50% more energy, and we'll look forward to it. I know we're going to have to use silent count. We know that. We could see that in the UND game, that it affected their game, and so we're preparing for that right now.
Speaking of North Dakota State, want to clarify one point, then get to something else. I mentioned Josh Hayes as a cornerback, because I was going off my sheets from 3 weeks ago, how things can change between when I put my sheets together before the first game got canceled and this one. Hayes is under the transfer portal. The veteran cornerback is no longer a member of the team. We didn't talk about the Bison linebacking crew. Cox, Hankey, Kaser. That's a pretty good group they've got at linebacker.
Yeah. Cox is playing, you know, in the shadow of his brother, but his brother was really, really good. This young man's good. Their Mike linebacker is a very physical guy. And then Kaser, we recruited him. Number one, a great young man and a really good football player. And so he'll play inside. If you take him outside, he'll go outside on a wide receiver, tight end type guy, and he'll do very well there. So those are good players.
When you're talking with your team, I thought it was interesting you mentioned earlier that they're not so much jacked or excited as just, you know, focused. That really is the thing. Or it's not about, hey, it's a big game, it's a big week. It's focused on the task at hand, and as you always say, 1-0 each week.
Yeah, and I'm not saying it's not a big game, and I'm not saying that we all don't feel that, but yeah. Why we don't have to say it. And you know, as you look back, hindsight's always great. Some years a while ago, we had built it up, and the guys felt like every play had to be made. Well, that never happens in the game of football. And so because of me or my approach, you know, I probably held guys back a little bit. And so, yes, 1-0, and as simple as 1-0 this play, and as simple as 11 guys being 1-0 with their job, as Coach Brown used to do it, used to say it, do your 1-11th. Do your 1-11th. When you've done that, good things happen.
We have talked about this so often, but especially in big games, especially on the road, it rings true, and it happened at Northern Iowa. minimizing mistakes. You're going to make a mistake or two, but you minimize A, the mistakes, and B, the impact of those mistakes. It's the old basketball term of live ball versus dead ball turnover. You make a dead ball turnover, it's much easier to correct it than it is if you make a live ball turnover. How you handle the reaction to those mistakes and minimizing them is important. You're laughing at me because I'm bringing up basketball
references.
I was
just trying to think, live or dead. One's
better than the other.
There's no doubt.
Tell me.
Minimize your mistakes. A turnover, huge. A penalty, not quite as bad, but whatever. Missed tackle, somebody else tackles them. That's not. But the biggest thing, I think, is the impact is not just the impact of the yards or the points or whatever. It's how the players and the team reacts to those things. You know, it's no different than a 50-yard field goal that puts you ahead with 2 minutes left. You got to be able to come back down and go out and play with confidence. So it's a chain of reactions to whatever the result is. That's why we use the term play in the present, positive or negative. Get yourself back in the framework to make play.
We have just under a minute. With everything this team has been through with COVID-19, now to have these three consecutive weeks off, to be back to football, playing for a conference title, how they've handled all of this. How proud are you and what stands out to you about how they've handled these past few weeks?
Well, I have not heard one negative out of our guys. I've not had anybody come to my office and say, why are we doing this, coach? I haven't had any coaches question anything. I think the loyalty, the commitment, again, we talk about one heartbeat, one voice. I've been impressed. And I keep saying I'm blessed to be the head football coach. This is another example.
Coach, appreciate the time. Best of luck on Saturday. Can't wait to see you on the field in the Fargo Dome.
And we're looking forward to it. Thanks, Tyler.
2:30 the kickoff. Radio coverage starts at 1:30 throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. For the coach, I'm Tyler Merriam. See you next time on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
John Stiegelmeier Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original, and your Jackrabbit headquarters. Also brought to you in part by First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Believe in Possibility, Member FDIC, Sanford Help. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Learn more at sanfordhealth.org. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. First.